urgent alert released after second killing spree in Texas targets kids. Here's who cops have in custody. Ever since Trump got into office, his vow to make America safe again by keeping illegal aliens and third world country vermin out of our country has been met with resistance from liberals. Despite ISIS and MS-13 gang members pouring into our country constantly, 261 sanctuary cities continue to harbor these people, blatantly refusing to uphold our nation's laws. After months of liberals fighting tooth and nail to defy Trump and harbor illegals, disturbing breaking news about what an illegal has done to a 7-year-old girl is making headlines, proving yet again why we need these degenerates rounded up and sent back to Mexico, as soon as freaking possible. For reasons that defy all logic, illegal alien Orlando Martinez, 25, thought it would be fun to take a joyride with his illegally obtained AR-15 and randomly begin shooting at cars along a 18-mile stretch of highway on South Austin's Interstate 35. Four innocent people, including a 7-year-old girl, were hit, where the child is now clinging to life after being shot in the head. Police identified a man accused of shooting at cars with an assault rifle along an 18-mile stretch of Interstate 35 Saturday morning. Late Sunday night, Orlando Martinez, 25, was charged with aggravated assault with a deadly weapon, a second-degree felony. Four people, including a 7-year-old girl, were hit. The child remains in critical condition as of Saturday evening. Austin police say the shooting began about 2 a.m. Saturday and ended around 3:15 a.m. Calls to 911 came in from multiple places along I-35, stretching from South Austin at Stassney Lane up to Wells Branch Parkway. "We have a lot of crime scenes. We have several people that were injured in this," said Austin Police Assistant Chief Joseph Chacon on Saturday. Officials arrested Martinez at a home on municipal traffic warrants Saturday. When they questioned him, he told them he had been drinking at the Nocturno nightclub and didn't remember much from that night, but he did remember waking up in a grassy median near the freeway, according to the affidavit. Martinez's bond is set at $1 million. According to Travis County Jail records, he has an Immigration and Naturalization Service detainer on him. The local news has more details, revealing that this crazed Mexican actually started his shooting spree at a gas station up the road. GVU reported. Shortly before 2:30 a.m., police responded to the Valero gas station at I-35 and Breaker Lane, and officers learned a man, later identified as Martinez, was seen pointing a Black R-style rifle at several customers who were in the parking lot. Police said in the affidavit they reviewed surveillance video to confirm reports provided by witnesses. While police were responding to the Valero station, officers were also called to the area of North Lamar and Masterson Pass for a report of three people, a 29-year-old male, a 31-year-old female, and a 7-year-old girl, shot inside a vehicle. The two adult victims suffered minor injuries, while the child suffered life-threatening injuries. Police said these victims reported they heard shots fired at them but did not get a look at the suspect's vehicle. "Is this enough bloodshed for you now, liberals?" Despite evidence of ISIS and dangerous MS-13 gangs pouring into our country, brain-dead liberals still want to blast Trump as a minority-hating bigot for wanting to crack down on immigration. President Trump has recently had to resort to calling for the arrests of mayors and governors across America, who keep vowing to harbor these dangerous individuals, just like Orlando Martinez. One of the liberal morons defiantly leading the charge against Trump's immigration policies over the past several months has been Cuban-born Miami Mayor Carlos Jiménez, who up until several days ago, continued to defiantly resist Trump's orders by harboring illegals. But Trump had finally had enough of idiots like Jiménez endangering the lives of Americans by refusing to comply with federal law, and set out to teach Jiménez a brutal lesson, threatening to pull a $480,000 federal police grant for non-compliance. After receiving the letter by Trump's Justice Department that he was about to be sued and on top of that have his funding yanked, the Hispanic mayor immediately began changing his tune, and decided to do the intelligent thing, and begin complying with federal orders.